You see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? Oh, the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Kaylee Dion with our national anthem.
Kaylee DeYoung with Kaylee DeYoung with 41 Action News, a meteorologist here in Kansas City with our national anthem. Good afternoon and welcome into the MISL playoffs. For the fourth straight year, the Missouri Comets and the Milwaukee Wave battle in the semifinal series. Hi, everybody. Nick Vassos live inside Independence Event Center. It is great to have you along in what is going to be a terrific semifinal series between high-scoring, familiar foes. If this series is anything like last year's, we are in for a wild ride, so fasten your seatbelts and adjust those tray tables. You'll remember last year, after dropping Game 1 at home to Milwaukee, the Comets scored game-winning goals in the final seconds of Game 2 and in the series-deciding minigame to advance to the MISL Championship, only to fall to the Baltimore Blast. The Comets finished the regular season with a 14-6 record, good for third place in the MISL standings. A Milwaukee Wave finished with a 16-4 mark, securing second place. All four of the Wave losses have come against the Comets. The Comets won the regular season series 4-2, but trail in the all-time series 16-12 and the playoff series 5-3. The MISL playoffs will feature four teams this year, and the defending champion Baltimore Blast earned the top seed, winning the regular season crown with a 17-3 record. Then Milwaukee at 16-4, the second seed, followed by Missouri, 14-6, the third seed, and then Syracuse with a 12-8 mark, claiming the last postseason ticket as the fourth seeds. The playoffs are already underway. They begin in Syracuse Friday night at One Center War Memorial Arena, the Blast winning 20-7. So game two in that series is set for 6:35 Central Time at Baltimore Arena. Game two in our series is tomorrow night, Monday Night Soccer at U.S. Cellular Arena in Milwaukee. Kickoff set for 7 o'clock. MilwaukeeWave.com for ticket information to game two. So how will this game play out? Really is anybody's guess. We do know the Comet must limit the Wave's Ian Bennett, the MISL Golden Boot Award winner with 27 goals, and Marcio Liete, as well as Luan Oliveira. The Comets must get off to a good start, and the Comets must continue their good defensive play and get offensive production from the scoring champion, Leo Gibson. Leo Gibson, the scoring and assist king this year. So it's Missouri and Milwaukee in game one of the semifinal series here live at Independence Event Center. Let's give you the starting lineups. First for the visiting Milwaukee Wave. In goal, it'll be Marcel Feenstra. Feenstra with a 13-3 record and a points against average around 10. The two defenders in front of him will be Fabinho and Victor Quiroz. Roaming the midfield, Milwaukee, Jonathan Greenfield and Mauricio Lete. The forward will be Nicolas Pereira. For the hometown Missouri Comets, Danny Waltman, the current player of the week, will start in goal. Nobody has played more minutes than Danny Waltman. Nobody has got more wins than Danny Waltman. Danny with 14-6 record, a save percentage of 732 and a points against average of 10.29. Playing defense in front of Danny, it'll be Stefan Stokic. Not a lot on the score stat sheets in terms of flashy statistics. He is always there in the right place at the right time. And Brian Harris, who leads the team in three-point goals and blocks, will play the other defender position. Ramon Palmer, much improved Ramon Palmer from Kingston, Jamaica. He'll start at one midfield position, and the Comets team captain, Vahid Asadpour, starts at the other. Vahid had been slow towards the end of the regular season with a knee strain. He'll be out there this afternoon in game one of this semifinal series. And finally for the Comets, starting up top, it'll be forward Leo Gibson. He is the scoring and assist king for Leo Gibson. 76 points on the year, 24 goals, 25 assists, and 11 in blocks. Well, we're going to need a good effort from Leo Gibson and the rest of the staff here against a Milwaukee Wave team that, well, quite frankly, has been a bit surprised at the way the Comets have played them towards the end of the regular season. You'll remember the Comets had two games at Milwaukee at the end of the regular season, and the Comets were able to win both of those games against the Wave. They won a 15-9 back on February 23rd, and the one that was really stinging at the end of the regular season was the Comets' 9-4 victory in Milwaukee over the Wave. That prevented Milwaukee from winning the regular season title, as well as secured the playoff matchup that we have here this afternoon. 2-3 seed. And again, this is the fourth straight year that the Comets and the Wave will meet in the semifinal round of the playoffs. What a dramatic series it was last year. And it, no doubt we're expecting much of the same in this contest coming up. Looks like players are just maintaining a little warm up here. We had some fog down on the field here, and it looks like we're just about set to go here. Milwaukee will have the ball to begin the first quarter, and in the center circle, it's Nicholas Pereira. A Wave coming in wearing their all-black uniforms, black tops, black shorts, black socks, trimmed in white, and we are underway. Game one of the semifinal series underway here live at Independence Event Center. Milwaukee. In the back, it's Victor Quiros. Comets come with some pressure just beyond the half line. Mauricio Liete plays it forward to Greenfield. Greenfield, a forward pass down to Pereira. On back to Jonathan. Now an east-west pass goes over to Liete on the far side, right in front of the Comets bench. Keith Tozer, the head coach for the Milwaukee Wave. Since 1992, Tozer has led the Milwaukee Wave 23 winning seasons. Here's Pereira with a drive into the box, and it's kicked out by the Comets. Here's Asadpour. Picks up the loose ball, crosses the half-point line. Now down to the corner it goes to Palmer. Ramon Palmer double-teamed by the Wave, and they win it back in a hurry. The Comets head coach is Vlatko Andonovsky. Andonovsky had been assistant for a couple of years before taking over the reins this year. And Andonovsky has his Comets team a 14-6 mark. And some of the postseason awards will be coming, including Coach of the Year. I wonder how many votes that Vlatko will get for Coach of the Year. Keith Tozer has won it 9 times over his brilliant, long career. Here's Judson McKinney. He's a player that would be up for Rookie of the Year. A fine defender for the Wave, plays it forward to Giuliano Oliveiro. A veteran kicks it away for the goal. On back to Oliveira, Luan, LSO. Right to the top of the arc, it goes to Ian Bennett, the Wave's leading scorer. Bennett won the Golden Boot Award as the league's top goal scorer. But again, Leo Gibson, the scoring and assist king. Gibson with 76 points on the year. And for Ian Bennett, he finished the regular season with 64 points. Here's John Sosa. Forward pass. That one to Robert Palmer, who's back after being injured a little a little bit at the end of the regular season. Palmer forward, Saint-Louis there, Zoots it just wide, couldn't get it on target. First good chance there for both teams by the Comets' Stephen Saint-Louis. Out of bounds, and the Comets are going to have it here. 12 and a half to play in the first. Scoreless inside Independence Event Center. Ryan Perez behind the ball along with Lucas Rodriguez. Perez peels off. Lucas fires it in there, and it hit Perez on the back. Bennett comes up with it and races across the line. Funnels it into the corner, and Waltman comes off his line to kick it away. Danny Waltman probably playing better than any keeper in the MISL towards the end of the regular season. Just really on his game. There the Wave have it. Pablo's there. Now to Munoz. We didn't see Carlos Munoz the last couple of times, but he's back on the Wave in the Wave lineup and out on the field. He's one of the many dangerous players on this Wave team. Milwaukee 16-4. On the regular season, all four of their losses coming against the Comets. Down to the right wing corner to Nicholas Pereira, marked by Sosa. John Sosa having moved back to defender from a midfield position when the Comets lost Cody Andrews. Comets today are without Cody Andrews. He's lost for the season with a broken ankle. Also, Alex Megson was hurt in the regular season finale at Milwaukee. He tore a knee ligament. Here's a drive, rebound out front. Waltman is there, spins away, funneled back in. Comets come away with it. Here's Harris on his horse, slides it through to Talu, shoots, and it goes in! Comets strike first! Max Talu, it's 2-0 Comets! What a ball by Harris! To Max Talu, that threaded the needle perfectly. And a timeout is called on the field. Take a look, that beautiful pass by Harris. And Talu with a good touch to send it over Feenstra, who went low. And the Comets on the board here, 2-0 over the Milwaukee Wave. Timeout on the field, quick break, and we'll be right back. 11:22 left of the opening quarter. It's the Missouri Comets 2, Milwaukee Wave nothing. You're watching the MISL Playoffs. Action back underway here in the first quarter, live at Independence Event Center. Nick Vassos with you. Glad to have you along wherever you might be watching this game. Game two in this semifinal series set for tomorrow night in Milwaukee. Here's Palmer trying to slide it over. Gets it over the Comets strike again. What beautiful footwork by Ramon. He slides it over to Gibson and he taps it in. It's now 4-0. I think it was Gibson on the far post. I wasn't sure. We'll take a look at it again here on the replay. Boy, Palmer was just itching to slide it over. He waited and waited and waited to the last possible minute and got it to the far post. It is Gibson. 4:08, the official time of the goal. Gibson from Palmer, and the Comets off to a good lead. Off to a good start. And that's been crucial in the Comets' recent success against Milwaukee. In the Comets' latest victories over the Wave, they've led at halftime. Still a long way to go till we get there. 10.5 to play in the first, but the Comets off to a good start here. These teams have played high-scoring games. You'll remember the first game of the season. The Wave came in here and won 23-21 in overtime, where Ian Bennett got the game-winning tally. And then the last game of the regular season, the Comets won 9-4. So these two teams who know each other very well can play different styles of games. Here's Oliveira. Luan moves to his right, shoots, save, rebound! It's kept out of the goal! And a foul called on Milwaukee. Tony Walls kept it out. Good team defense, and once again, Danny Waldman, here's another look at it. Oliveira cut it back to his right, put the right footer on there. Danny got a piece of it, and the tap in there from Walls just off the mark. Comets in their last third. Here's Asadpour and Danny Waldman. Here's Danny, plays it forward. That one picked off. Danny scrambles back and catches that one and says, all right, guys, let's do this again. Lays it off to Brian Perez. Perez down to Vaheed. Here comes Milwaukee with some pressure on the Comets' yellow line. Over to Sosa, on back to Danny. Comets are gonna go for some changes here. Lucas Rodriguez comes on. Now they play it to Waldman. Danny jogs it across the yellow line and then boots it into the left wing corner for Gibson. Gibson is there, heels it back, out in front, Talu with a scissor kick from the seat of his pants. Easy save made by Feenstra. Out to Ribeiro. Correction, Fabinho. Now over to Victor Quiroz. Back to Victor. Pass there. Touched by the Comets into Munoz. Kicked away. Oliviero is over there along with Bennett. Talu comes away with it. Ball rebounds over to the near side, and we've got a foul called on Victor Quiroz. And that'll be Victor's first foul here. 8.5 to play in the first. 4-0 Comets. John Sosa. Stefan Stokic, the defenders. Ramon Palmer, Lucas Rodriguez, and Leo Gibson out there up top for the Comets. Here's Palmer. Boy, Palmer's demonstrated a lot of good footwork. He is a very technical player that is good in tight spaces and in traffic. Here's Stokic. Back to Danny. Danny with a 14-6 regular season record forward to Leo. Leo, 27 assists and 76 points on the year. Leo lost it. Milwaukee wins it. Leaves it off for Greenfield. Seven and a half now on the clock. First quarter. Forward it comes to Everton. Back to Greenfield. Now far side, Liete. Liete with his head up, looks, fires one into the far post. Greenfield was near, just about a step and a half away, and that would have been a good chance. Now Heverton almost deflects one in. Comets clear it away, and it bounds into the stands just over the Wave bench. Timeout, official timeout with 7:04 left to play in the first. Comets 4, Wave nothing. You're watching the MISL playoffs. Glad to have you along. 6:56 left to play in the first. Comets, a 4-0 lead in game one of this semifinal series between Milwaukee and Missouri here live at Independence Event Center. This will be a best of three series. Game two is set for tomorrow night. Monday night soccer at U.S. Cellular Arena. Kickoff set for 7 o'clock. Got a whistle and a foul called on the Comets team captain, Vahid Asadpour. Asadpour finished the season with 57 points, 20 goals, 15 assists. Asadpour was slowed by a knee strain towards the end of the regular season, missed several games. He was atop of the MISL scoring charts for much of the regular season until he got hurt. Judson McKinney. He's got a trio of Comet players around him, including one of the newest Comets player, Alain Mattingu. Mattingu is just his third game for the Comets, and this is a playoff game, so life is coming at him very fast in this game. Have to keep an eye on him. Pablo feeds into the middle to Pereira, trying to turn Harris. Banged it off the boards, and it goes through to Saint-Louis. Saint-Louis plays it up to the half line, and it's a race to the ball, and Oliveira wins it for the Wave. Over to the far boards. Ian Bennett gets by Mattingu. Bennett playing forward to Oliveira. Harris knocked it away. Brian looking for some teammates and running, but nothing into black jerseys here. Now a scramble for the ball in the referee's crease, and we've got a foul called on Milwaukee. Coach Keith Tozer is on the bench there, just pacing back and forth. Now finally turns, faces the field, and crosses his arms across his chest. Comets head coach, Vladko Andonovsky, looks on. His hands behind his back. Meanwhile, here's Robert Palmer. Over to Asadpour. Forward to Gibson. Gibson trying to lay it back to Vahid. Broke it up by the Wave. Now the ball kicked into the corner. Oliveira was there. Boots it up towards Judson McKinney. Got a whistle and a foul. And this one will go against Missouri. Didn't see who got the foul there. Might have been Leo Gibson. Correction, number 12, Robert Palmer. Here's Oliveira. Down the near boards. Comets broke it up, and Palmer will boot it long. Comets will sit back defensively right on the half line. That's where they'll pick up the Wave. Comets nursing a 4-0 lead here early. That one took a funny hop, and scampered over the top of the plexiglass, goes out of bounds. The Comets will have it. Kind of a break there for Missouri. Danny Wallman and John Sosa will change positions, and Sosa will boot it towards Leo Gibson, but one hop off the carpet and into the area where public address announcer Ed Bishop is announcing the game there live to the fans here. Looks like a midfield pressure here by the Wave. They win it back. Here's a drive from three, an easy save made by Waltman. That drive coming from Munoz. Danny throws out to Gibson. Gibson is taken down and a foul called by the Wave. Ryan Sigich, one of our referees this afternoon. Ryan is the director of officiating for the MISL. Here's Rodriguez to Palmer, played back to Sosa. What a season by Sosa. And how about the finish to the season by Lucas Rodriguez? He was amazing in those games against Milwaukee on the road. Now Danny. Near side Lucas. On over to Sosa. Sosa plays it forward to Mattingu. Mattingu off the boards, trying to go around the defender in number 15, Tony Walls. Broke it up by the Wave, and they get it back to Feenstra. Now Feenstra with a line drive. That one headed back in by the Comets. A drive by Mattingew just off target. Almost a mistake there in the last third by the Wave. Here's another look at it here. There's Mattingew's drive. That one was close to the post. Forward it goes to Bennett. Ian Bennett slides it to Pereira. Pereira bangs it in there looking for a teammate. Nobody home. Waltman's there. Danny holding it and holding it. On over to Leo. Here comes some pressure from the Way. Good pass by Gibson out to Sosa. And the Comets got something on here. Here's Sosa moving down to the corner. Sosa double teamed and his touch let him down. It's picked up there by Pereira. Now the Comets trying to win it back. There's Sosa off the boards. He fouls Ian Bennett. And John will jog back the other way. Foul called on Missouri with 2:37 left to play in the first. Comets lead 4-0 on goals by Max Talut and Leo Gibson. Those tallies coming in the first 5 minutes in the opening quarter. Here's Giuliano Oliveira. The veteran plays it back to Victor Quiros, who bangs it off the boards. I know that was a good play there by Quiros and Oliveira, and Jules could not put it on target. Now into Liete. That was about the best scoring opportunity the Wave have had here in the first 15 minutes. Here's Harris racing down the left side. Boop from behind, and a foul is called. Ryan Harris probably going to have a few strawberries there. Sliding several feet here on the AstroTurf. Behind the ball, it's Brian Perez. He's got Harris front and center. Here's Brian. He had 5 3-point goals during the regular season. He was among the league leaders. Brian's game has steadily improved since he won Rookie of the Year 4 years ago. Now Stokic. But first, a whistle, foul on Missouri. That'll go against San Luis. That's San Luis' first foul. Coming up on 90 seconds to play in the first quarter. 90 seconds. Down to the corner, here's Everton. Away from the goal to Quiros. Victor front and center, it goes to Greenfield. Now right side, Munoz with a drive, and on the log roll is Stokic, sacrificing his body. Actually, that drive coming from McKinney. Meanwhile, Munoz has it forward to Everton. His touch boots the ball back to the half line. Bennett will reset with a pass to Feenstra. Marcel Feenstra, 13-3 on the year. Marcel has gone the rest of the way during the regular season, and he'll go all the way in the playoffs here because Vordberg is out with an injury. Nick Vordberg, their other fine keeper for the Milwaukee Wave. Now here's Oliveira in the corner. Squirts through, and Danny Waltman's got it. Looking for the break. Instead, we'll hold on to it and lays it off to Asadpour. Vahid surveys the field. He's got Heverton right in front of him. We'll play it back to Danny. 25 seconds left in the opening quarter. Here's Waltman. Danny Waltman up towards the half line. Here's Danny down to the corner with a pass to Asadpour. And back to Palmer, under 10 to play in the first quarter. Max Talut with it, 5 seconds left. Max just fires it down there, and that'll do it for the first 15 minutes. Comets with 2 goals, one by Max Talut and Leo Gibson. The assist from Brian Harrison, Ramon Palmer. Comets 4, Milwaukee Wave nothing. You're watching the Major Indoor Soccer League Playoffs.
board. We've got ourselves a nice Italian leather recliner. So my question for you, Stephanie, which it retails, if you went in any other store, close to $1,400. But if you walked into the 291 23rd Street Shocking Prices location,
second quarter just about ready to start. Again, glad to have you with us wherever you're watching. It's the Comets and Wave in game one of this semifinal series in the MISL playoffs. First quarter stats, the Comets out shooting Milwaukee. 4-3. Danny Wallman has made four saves. Marcel Feenstra one. The Comets with seven fouls and the Wave with six. Both teams switch ends, and the Comets will now move it right to left. Forward it goes to Gibson. Gibson trying to play it into Rodriguez, and Milwaukee takes the errant pass and will work out of its own end. Forward it goes to Pereira. Played back to Fabinho. And forward once again to Greenfield. Wave slowly but surely pressing up. Here's Greenfield. That one deflected off a player and had a lot of English on it, and Waltman leaned forward. Munoz wins the ball from Harris, and Brian Harris is going to be rung up for a penalty. Harris took out Munoz. And there's going to be some discussion here. We just saw the blue card, but Harris lost the ball and Munoz was headed towards the goal, and Brian really cut him down hard. Munoz is shaking up. Looks like he's holding his left shin. We'll see what the ruling is. It's a blue card, what we're seeing now, but nothing else.
I can have Lindsay bring it down.
I wonder if they're discussing if there's going to be any additional penalty here to Brian. We're going to get a good view of it here. Brian lost it, and then from behind just chopped him down hard. Brian Harris.
Number 25, Brian Harris. 2 minutes for tripping. Since it was a major foul, a yellow card was issued, and he was issued an additional 5 minutes.
Yeah.
But the Comets will only be short for 2 minutes.
Okay. So Brian was given the two-minute penalty for tripping, and then an additional 5 minutes for it being, I guess, a flagrant foul. So the Comets are going to be short 2 minutes, but Harris will be out of the game for a total of 7 minutes, and he will not be able to get back into the game until the next guaranteed substitution, and that's going to be problematic for the Comets. Brian Harris is one of the Comets' best, if not the best, defender. 14-13 left to play here in the second, and things have all of a sudden changed. Milwaukee goes on the power play here, and the Comets are going to be a man down. And typically, Harris would be out there on the man down team, but he's in the penalty box. So it's Milwaukee underway here with a drive. Gibson, Stokic, Palmer, and Mattingew, the Comets' newcomer, are out there on the man down team, all in front of Danny Waltman. Power play team for Milwaukee includes Victor Quiros, Ian Bennett, Nicholas Pereira, Luan Oliveira. Here's Saint Louis motoring in, and we've got a foul called on Saint Louis. Rounding out the power play team is Judson McKinney for the Wave. Saloui goes off, Stokic comes on. Here's Kiros. Liete, front and center. 1:30 left on the advantage. Oliveira with a drive. Wolfman flying to his right makes the save. Oh, Margaret, what a play by Danny Waltman. This will be a restart here at the top of the arc, and Liete will trigger a dangerous area. Comets a man down here, leading 4-0. Here's Liete. Over to Bennett, shot saved with his feet. That time, Waltman with the save. Now another loose ball, here's Bennett again. Waltman slams the door against Ian Bennett, the Golden Boot Award winner. Danny is up and throwing long. Saloui comes in with an aggressive run towards Liete. Now Saloui goes off, Palmer comes in. Wave still on the power play, under a minute to go. Here's Kiros, right side Liete. Liete down to the corner. Oliveira skip past Kiros, left wing. Now front and center Liete, marked by Robert Palmer. Now a drive. Waltman got a piece of it out in front and some help there. I believe it was Mattingew. Helped deflect that one and keep it out of the goal. Good team defense by the Comets. 30 seconds left on the advantage to Milwaukee. Foul called on Missouri and they'll get a restart here near the right wing corner. A little bit of frustration showing here on the Wave players. Comets are holding it here. They are working really hard. Here's the restart. Oliveira to Liete. Back to Oliveira. Now Liete left side Kiros. Gibson comes in, knocks it away momentarily. 16 seconds left. Here's Liete, marked by Stokic. Liete moves to his right, down to the corner to Oliveira. Inboard pass, still loose. Kicked out of bounds by the Comets. And that's going to be a restart at the top of the arc. 6 seconds left on the power play to Milwaukee. So a good restart here. Can the Comets keep them out of the net? Here's Liete. Over to Banks, I believe. Comets break away with it. Penalties over. Max Talou comes back in. Both teams at even strength. Liete. Now Gibson up with it. Here's Leo back the other way. Leo into open space, leads Asadpour, over to Mattingew, still loose, oh, they couldn't close the deal. Now Bennett on the counter, here comes Ian Bennett the other way. Ian Bennett can't get a shot on goal, Waltman comes out. A brilliant play by Danny. Now Asadpour, right wing for Sosa. Sosa marked by Kiros. And a foul called on the Wave. What action here, end to end. Carlos Munoz with the foul. Once again, here's Bennett down there, and Danny came out in a terrific slide as he touched the ball first. Great timing by the Comets keeper, Danny Waltman. What's going on here? It looks like Ryan Sigich, John Sosa, and Vahid Asadpour are all talking, and Sigich is asking John to leave the field of play. Comments at... We got... That's... Okay, now we got players back in there. I'm not exactly sure why Ryan was asking him to go off. Maybe... Couldn't make the sub there on the dead ball. All right, both teams even strength. Comets still hanging on to a 4-0 lead with 11 and a half to play in the first half. Waltman on up to Leo. Leo to Stokic. Stefan, one touch, moves to his right, splits the defense, chases the ball. Ramon Palmer trying to gather it up. Now it's a 50-50 ball, and it's touched by Munoz. We've got a shaken up Milwaukee Wave player on the field here. It looks like the ball may have hit someone in the face. I can't see who that is. It's Victor Kiros who comes up a little shaky, holding his Maybe he took either a finger to the eye or the ball hit him in the eye. Looks like Victor is going to be okay. Victor Quiros played 2 years with the Wichita Wings before coming over here to play for the Milwaukee Wave. Terrific defender. 11:07 left to play in the first half. The Wave now have outshot the Comets 5-4. Now Ryan Sigich comes over to the referee's crease. And we are good to go. Here's Danny. Up the middle it comes to Asadpour. Vahid will turn and face the defender Greenfield. Over to Palmer, Ramon Palmer. Tried to slide it through a defender. Greenfield nearly came up with it. Ramon scrambles back, able to get it over to Stokic. Good pressure here by the Wave, almost winning the ball. Comets trying to get it across the half line. They do, but right to a Wave player. Now Palmer played it off the boards to himself, and the Wave will reset. Here's Pablo. Pablo in the center circle. On over to Greenfield. All kinds of traffic over there. And almost a chance there by the Comets. The pass a bit strong. And here come the Wave. Here's Liete with some open space. Liete with a drive. Oh, that one deflected off a player. That might have been off Oliviero. Ricochets into the corner. Now Bennett with a drive. That one blocked out of bounds by the Comets.
Shocking prices. As prices are low, they'll blow your mind.
Be a free kick to Milwaukee on the near touchline. 4-0, Comets over the Wave. Max Talou and Leo Gibson with the goals. Brian Harris and Ramon Palmer the assist. Brian Harris remains in the penalty box. He can't return to the game until that 5 minutes is over, and he can get a, once there is a guaranteed substitution, he can re-enter the game. Got a restart coming up to the Wave in the right wing corner. Here's Liete behind the ball. Liete into the middle. Quiros was there on the doorstep, could not finish. Outlet to Asadpour. Vahid and Bennett both giving chase. And it comes out. Vahid fanned on the shot at point blank range. Feenstra out to Heberton. Now to Liete. Liete moves to his right. He is knocked down on a foul called on the Comets. That'll go against Alan Mattingew. Correction, Robert Palmer. That's Robert's third foul. He'll have to watch it for the rest of the first half here. Liete, left side, Quiros with a drive, save made by Waltman. We've been saying a lot here, and that in the last 5 minutes, Danny has made several big saves, and he's been helped by his teammates in front of him. Into the right wing corner, there's Heberton. Marked by two Comet defenders, banged off the glass. Waltman's got it again. Comet's doing a good job at funneling that ball successfully into Danny, where he's able to distribute it out of the back. Danny Waltman, most wins and most minutes in goal. Now Perez with some space. Tried to slide it over to Rodriguez, broken up by the Wave. Hops out of bounds, and it'll stay with the Comets. Sosa on back to Stokic. Now Perez and Stokic. Here's John Sosa. Sosa played it right up the middle of the field. Quiros with a touch, and the Wave will boot it long and go for some changes. Here's Sosa back there. Careful, he got Quiros right on his back. That's a foul against Milwaukee's Victor Quiros.
Milwaukee foul number 23, Victor Quiros is second.
That's Victor's second foul. These two teams tomorrow night at U.S. Cellular Arena, 7 o'clock kick, Monday Night Soccer. Comets, the giveaway, Perez! Oh, the wave gave it away right to Perez, who had an open shot and just couldn't find the open area. Boy, a mistake in the last third by the wave. Here comes Stokic. Stefan gets tripped up in the midfield. Oh, and that's not even a foul. The fans are holding their blue cards. They are chewing on Ryan Sigich. Pereira down to the corner to McKinney, and he hit the post. Oh, he hit it twice. Oh, Margaret, how did that stay out? Handball is called against Milwaukee. Oh, my goodness. How frustrating is that? Take a look at this again. McKinney fired it. Ding dong off the post. And then the rebound hit it again. And there at the back line, some Comet player cleared it away. Just amazing. Wow. Good replay, guys. Oh, that was an own. That was an own. That was Ramon Palmer who touched it again and almost knocked it in. Wow. Oliveiro around the glass and shoots across the Comets' goal to the other side. Picked up by Asadpour. Ah, Vahid had it stripped. McKinney is there to Oliveiro. Right at the top of the arc. Shot. Ding dong off the crossbar. Kicked away by the Comets. McKinney with his head in his hands after it hit the crossbar. Oh, my. Milwaukee needs to stay with it. They're getting chances. They just need to keep creating them. Here's Kiros down to the corner. Oliveiro with a wall pass. Ball cleared away by the Comets. What a first half it's been so far this afternoon. On back to Marcel. Feenstra plays it up to Munoz, chugging across the line. Near side, Kiros. Now Greenfield. Under six to play in the first half. 4-0 Comets. Over the top of the defense, Fabinho hits it on the volley. One hop and Danny's got it. Danny underhands to Gibson. He fanned on it. Picked up there by the wave. Comets get back defensively. Leo goes down. Picked off there by Lucas, and Lucas is cut down like a tree, and a foul called on the wave. Good article in the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel online asking Coach Keith Tozer if this game or his team is seeking revenge, and he said, quote, "I read a quote the other day that if you seek revenge, build two coffins," Tozer said. So this is not really a revenge factor. I think we just need to come out, make sure no matter what game tactics you play, it has to have effort. I think on the effort side, we've lacked a little bit, which is surprising. The Wave are putting forth good effort here. They trail the Comets by four with the ball. 5 minutes to play. Here's a drive by Fabinho, and it's blocked out of bounds by the Comets. The Waves' leading scorer, Ian Bennett, looked at the match a little bit differently. He said, "They," meaning the Comets, "have been a thorn in our butts, and we've got to try to get that thorn out," Bennett said. "They beat us last year in the last seconds, and that is still on our minds." Milwaukee still thinking about what happened last year. 4:58 left to play in the first half. Comets 4, Wave nothing. You're watching the Major Indoor Soccer League playoffs. These two teams are the highest scoring teams in the MISL. The Comets scored 329 points, again, most in the league, and the Waves scored 325 points second, just 5 points less than the Missouri Comets. So Milwaukee Wave Founded in 1984, they are a six-time league champion. Keith Tozer's won more games than anybody in North America. And the general, as we mentioned earlier, has been coaching since 1992. He's been the coach of the year nine times. His coaching career spans the 80s with the Los Angeles Lasers, then the Atlanta slash Kansas City Attack before landing in Milwaukee in 1992. And being there ever since. The Comets are looking for their first indoor championship since the 96-97 season. That team was coached by Jim Schwab, and the general manager, Zoran Savic, was the GM at the time. Then the Kansas City Attack swept the Cleveland Crunch 4-0. That was the last indoor championship that Kansas City has won. Missouri Comets are hoping to take the first step here this afternoon. Here's Rodriguez with the ball. Lucas got some space. Lucas to San Luis! Comets goal! It is 6-0. What a play by Rodriguez as he drew the defenders over. And once they committed, he slid it over to San Luis, and it was an easy tap-in goal. Another look at it here, San Luis. His first playoff goal for the Missouri Comets. And Lucas Rodriguez continues his good play as the Comets now have a 3-goal lead here with 4:44 left to play in the first half. Kicked out of bounds by Milwaukee, and Jonathan Greenfield just puts both hands on the hip and then one hand on the chin and kind of goes, Comets will restart it. They float one into the wave side of the field, and Stokic comes over the back of Luan Salas Oliveira, and foul called on Stokic. Looks like Luan's going to be all right. Greenfield's pass was deflected by Gibson. Stokic has it for the moment, but under a lot of pressure here. Now touch deep into Comet territory. Palmer is there, gets loose. Pereira's close by as well. Now McKinney hits the deck. Everybody giving chase. Sosa finally comes up with it, slides it forward to Max Talu. Comet's on the counter. Here's Talu, shot save! Made by Feenstra. Feenstra's save went out of bounds. The Comets will have it on the far touchline here. Talu plays it back to San Luis. And then all the way back to Danny. Comets will hold it here. On back to Danny. The wave right now comfortable sitting back towards the half line. There's Milan Ivanovic into the game. Not sure if this might be the first time he's entered the game. Long pass from Danny. Broken up by the wave. Picked up there. Pereira tries to turn. Runs into a couple of Comet defenders. And then down to the corner. Here's Gibson. And that one booted out of bounds. The Comets are going to have it on the restart here right at the top of the arc. Let's see what the Comets do here. You've got Asadpour on the floor right now. He has 5 restart goals on the season. And I believe that led the league. There's a timeout on the field, and we'll keep it right here and let you know that the other series going on in the MISL playoffs, the Baltimore Blast and the Syracuse Silver Knights. Baltimore the top seed, Syracuse the number 4 seed. That series is led by Baltimore 1-0. This past Friday night, Baltimore winning 20-7 over Syracuse. Game 2 of that series is set for Tuesday night, 6:35 Central Time, at Baltimore Arena. Game 2 of this series is set for tomorrow night at U.S. Cellular Arena. The Comets and Wave in Game 2, 7 o'clock You can watch that game at cometsindoorsoccer.com. For those of you that are watching today's game in Milwaukee, milwaukeewave.com. For ticket information, just $10 for the Comets and Wave in game two of this semifinal MISL playoff series. So they break the huddle. See what the Comets are going to do here. Rodriguez and Sosa. Lucas down to the corner to Vahid. His drive is saved by Feenstra. 3:17 left to play. Feenstra on up to Bennett. Bennett near side, McKinney. McKinney's pass touched by Gibson and picked off by the Comets. Here's Perez trying to slide it through to Rodriguez, broken up by the Wave. Milwaukee finishing the regular season 1-2. Brian Harris back into the game. His 7-minute penalty is now over. That's good news for the Comets side. Here's Perez over to Gibson, trying to float it over the top, and it goes out of bounds. Good try there by Leo Gibson. Leo's mom watching in Cleveland once again this afternoon. Leo had a terrific game on his mom's birthday. I think he scored 9 points in that game. I think that was against the Pennsylvania Roar. Here's Kiros with a drive. That one just wide. Rebound off target. 2:25 left to play in the first half. 6-0. Missouri over Milwaukee. Down to the corner. I think that's Oliviero there. Comets wrestle it free. Get it out to Harris. Here's Bryan. A left footer ding-dong off the post. Rebound off to Milwaukee. Munoz weaves his way through a bunch of defenders, and then Harris chops him down to the midfield area, and a foul against the Comets.
Comets foul, number 25, Brian Harris is first.
You see Ramon Palmer and Carlos Munoz doing some shoving there away, off camera and away from the ball. Meanwhile, Greenfield brings it up. Poise is going to be a factor in the second half. As many times as these teams have met recently, given the playoff history, it's going to be a factor. So far, both teams have remained calm. 1.5 to play in the first half. Comets 6-0 over the Milwaukee Wave. Here's Marcio Liete. Near side, Kiros. Greenfield, front and center. Now Liete. Marcio, one of the offensive leaders for the Wave. Forced out wide by Palmer. Palmer got a piece of it. The ball bounds into the corner. Harris shields away the defender, and Waltman's got it. Out to Asadpour. Comets team captain shoots it along the boards. Here's Talu. Talu's got it. Tries to cut it back to Gibson on the far side. Good defensive play there by Fabinho and Greenfield. Now just off the bench here was Everton, and he touched it and thought he might have a chance here against Asadpour, but out of bounds it goes, and the Comets will have it inside their last third. 46 seconds left to play in the half. Loose ball picked up by St. Louis. Stefan, fire save made by Feenstra. Pablo comes up with it, 27 seconds left. Now Fabinho, right into the breadbasket of Danny Waltman. Here's Asadpour, back to Danny. Now Harris, well booted up to the center circle. Banged back in there by Fabinho. Comes out to Pablo. Pablo front and center, 1 second left, fires off St. Louis, and the horn sounds, and the Comets have shut out the Milwaukee Wave in the first 30 minutes of this semifinal game here live at Independence Event Center. What a defensive effort by the Comets. And goals by Max Talu, Leo Gibson, and Stefan St. Louis. The Comets, Missouri Comets 6, Milwaukee waved nothing. Halftime is next. You're watching the Major Indoor Soccer League Playoffs. right. Here we go. Here we go for the third quarter. The Comets lead 6-0 over the Milwaukee Wave. Comets were outshot, total shots on goal, 14-9 in favor of Milwaukee. Total shots on goal, 9-7 in favor of the Wave. Danny Waltman made 9 saves in the first half, and Marcel Feenstra made a total of 4. Comets lead 6-0, and we saw the frustrations of the Milwaukee Wave at the end of the first half. Spotted on the field was Mauricio Liete, who allegedly shoved senior referee Ryan Sigich after the horn sounded in the first half. And there was quite the discussion there. And now there's more talk in front of the Comets goal right now. This is getting heated right now. By the way, it's the second time the Comets have shut out the Wave this season. And this is only the third time that Milwaukee has been shut out for a half during the regular season. 13:54 left to play in the third. Nick Vassos live inside Independence Events Center. We are now joined by a former member of the MLS Columbus Crew, former member of the MISL's Omaha Vipers, and former Missouri Comet Ryan Jung is in our broadcast position here as we look at play. Milwaukee holding the ball here. And Ryan, you were there for the first half. Pretty impressive shutting out Milwaukee for the first 30 minutes. What's your observations of the game?
It was one of the best first half I've seen this team play all year. And it's not even the fact that they shut Milwaukee out. It's more along the lines of the way everybody contributed at some point or another. It was a huge team effort in the first half, and it's just going to carry over to the second half. Like right here, I mean, Stefan Stokic is playing up front. You don't see that very often, but the way the team plays, it builds up, and he can actually get up front and has a chance to score. Ramon Palmer saving the ball off the line, and everybody's put in 100% effort the whole entire half, and that's what it takes in the playoffs.
Well, we've seen some frustration, and the Comets have been, they've been fortunate. Oh, on the restart there, Rodriguez hit it a little high. Gibson with the rebound. Gibson hammers it in there. It's still loose. Out front shot. Goal!
That's what Leo does.
Oh, Leo Gibson. Tough shell for Grandma Keeps the Cookies. And the Comets extend their lead. It's now 8-0.
That's what you love to see. Just the fight, the whole buildup. It doesn't go on the first shot. It bounces out. I mean, that's indoor, and no one plays indoor better than Leo. He's got a knack just to score goals however he can. Unbelievable.
It got by Feenstra and then loose out front, and Leo just got behind it, turned, and fired it in there. Leo's second playoff goal of the game, and the Comets extend their lead 8-0.
I think that's the hardest thing as a defender. No matter how hard you're trying to clear the ball, if you don't clear it, it's so dangerous. Marcel makes a great save. The defenders are scrapping, and the ball ends up in the net. You don't really think anything of it until you go back and film, and you're like, what do I need to do better? How did that happen? But then on the same note, as an attacker, why would you not stand
on the goal? That's a penalty. Carlos Munoz cut down by Ramon Palmer of the Comets, and the Wave are going to go on their second power play of the game. Palmer will be sent off for tripping for 2 minutes. 2:40, the official time of the penalty, and Palmer goes off. So the man down team for the Comets will be Harris Palmer, Robert Palmer, Stefan Stokic, and Leo Gibson. We also should note that the Comets were fortunate in that Milwaukee hit two posts, hit a crossbar, and were unlucky several times. Comets were actually were fortunate that Milwaukee was unable to finish many of the chances that they had. So luck has been on the Comets' side. We'll see what happens here in the second half, and already a penalty against the Comets. Here's a drive. It got through, but off target. Harris will bang it off the glass and clear it to the half line. Power play team for the Wave includes Victor Quiros, Marcio Liete, Nicholas Pereira, Ian Bennett, Manluan Oliveira. Here's Quiros, touched by Harris. Harris has those bright orange boots on this afternoon.
Trying to match his beard.
Here's Quiros. Down to the corner. Pass intercepted by Gibson. Leo pops it up into the air. Still banging away, and it finally ends up in the hands of Waltman, who's throwing long for Harris. Here's Brian Harris, by the way, who has two shorthanded goals this season.
In one game.
And exactly. 11 and a half to play. Ryan Jung, Nick Vassos with you live at Independence Event Center. Here's Gibson. Hey, it's taken down in the midfield, and a foul! A penalty coming up against Milwaukee. Nicholas Pereira is going to be sent off. So that'll be a four-on-four situation here for the next 56 seconds.
A lot of fans don't appreciate those kind of calls, but as a player, I mean, you have to give a blue card there. You expect one from the refs, and the refs know that as well. It's a chance to counter. It's a chance to get into the offensive side of the field, and if you prevent that, whether there's guys back or not, you still have to make
And that's in a part of the field, Ryan, that you know, we see many fouls here to allow the defense to get back. I've heard players call that a professional foul sometimes right there in the midfield area. So that's probably what Nicholas was thinking. Oh, the giveaway.
Well done, Danny.
Oh, Quiros! And Danny makes an unbelievable save. Unbelievable save by Danny Waltman.
He's in the zone.
Oh, man. Look at it again. The Comets lost. Quiros wins the ball and then fires a shot. Danny reaches back and makes the save. How would you describe Danny's play here in the last few games of the regular season and how he's doing here tonight?
I think the one word that sums it up the best is focus. He's probably more focused now more than anybody, any of the four teams that are playing in this in the playoffs. His mindset is a championship, and he's playing like he wants one really bad.
Out front with it is Liete. Liete tried to slide it through to Bennett. Liete gets it back. His drive blocked by Harris of the Comets. We have 6 seconds left on the 4v4, and then the Comets are going to go on the power play, and it rolls past Bennett. He shakes his head again and into the breadbasket of Waltman. Up, Gibson gave it away. Here's Quiros. Now the Comets are on the power play. Gibson, or correction, Bennett was there flashing in on the header. There's Bennett out front again. Now Palmer back into the game. On up to Sosa. Now Gibson. Comets on the power play here for the next 43 seconds. On back to Asadpour.
If they score here, this is going to be huge.
Here's Sosa. On over to Vahid. Asadpour front and center to John. Left back for Lucas. Now over to Asadpour. Fires, ding dong off the post. Gibson to the far side, that one off the inboards. 19 seconds left on the Comets' advantage. Left side Asadpour. Vahid with a drive off the window. Sosa will rebound, shot no good. Now Vahid again, Feenstra makes the save. 4 seconds left on the advantage. Gibson a drive. And a second one. Look out, folks, up and over the glass. 1 second left on the Comet power play here.
1 second left in the penalty. 1 second left in the penalty.
And Pereira came out of the box a little bit early. Pereira's going to have to go into the penalty box here. And Feenstra signaling to his team to go long. Feenstra winds up. throws it long. Touched by Sosa, up to San Luis. Here's Stefan with a drive, and that one blocked by Judson McKinney. Here comes Waltman across the line. 9 minutes to play in the third. Comets lead 8-0. Here's San Luis. Stefan still going forward. Ball loose out front. Oh, and the Waves save it off the line. What a play by the Milwaukee defenders. I think that was Luan Salas Oliveira there on the line. We'll get a replay of it here. They got it by Feenstra over the top of his head. Yeah, that was LSO there to block it off the line. Good defensive play there by the Wave striker. Game two of this semifinal series coming up tomorrow night at U.S. Cellular Arena. Kickoff is set for 7 o'clock. Baltimore leads 1-0 in the other semifinal series over Syracuse. Game two there set for Tuesday in Baltimore. Here's Palmer with some space. Front center,
yes.
Oh, they carved him up that time. It's 10-0 Comets. What a play.
Just like they drew it up.
What do you see here, Ryan?
This is exactly what you want after all the tension that's been built up. These are the kind of goals that are going to come. They're going to lay it down, trying to stick them. Ramon has a great touch around the defender, lays it off, open net, easy tapping for Sosa. Doesn't get much better than that. Picture perfect indoor goal.
Rodriguez gets his second assist on the night. Correction, Palmer gets his second assist on the night. Sosa, his first goal. 10-0 Comets over the Wave with 8:12 left to play. Fans, there is still a lot of time here. Here's Munoz in the box. He goes down. Danny made the save, but a foul called on the Comets. Holy cow, that was close. Key Tozer's got his hands up in the air on either side saying, where was the penalty there? Here's a drive off the wall. A rebound. Perez comes up with the foul there. Milwaukee will reset their offense. Both teams at even strength. Yeah, under 8 minutes to play in the third. Everton. Got it left wing, facing Brian Harris of the Comets. Now Greenfield's got it. Down to the corner it goes to Everton. Brian Harris got a touch on it there. Back to Everton. Turns, fires, save made by Danny. Not a lot of pace on that one, but Danny the right spot.
They're showing great patience as a defensive unit. Milwaukee can move the ball better than anybody in this league. And the fact that the Comets just sit there and wait for that one mistake or the guy to get a shot off, I mean, they've played that all year. And that's how they beat Milwaukee. That's how you beat a team like that. That's how you beat a Baltimore. You just got to be patient. You watch these guys play, these guys meaning Milwaukee and Baltimore. I mean, those guys, they pick and choose when they go forward, when they play a ball through, whether they shoot or they pass. I mean, those guys know the game to a T, and that's what makes them so hard to beat. And the Comets are getting to that level now, and you see it based off of, I mean, the way they played this first half and the first part of this quarter. I mean, these guys are just, they're patient, they're not forcing a lot, and I don't think Milwaukee was expecting that, and it's kind of showing now. Milwaukee's kind of on their heels, and the Comets are going full throttle forward.
There's Hector, the leader of Labatta KC. Ryan, you've seen Hector there at so many games, banging the drum. So many great Comet fans, and he's one of the best. He's at all of the Comets games, and he's at all the sporting games. Yeah, he might be one of big-time soccer ambassadors.
I don't think I've met someone more enthusiastic about the game of soccer. And even indoor, I mean, it's not technically just soccer. It's
right.
A bunch of different combinations. You got the hockey arena. You play on turf. You have 2 and 3 point goals. And Hector has been, and everybody he's brought in have been huge. Last year with the drums, the I Believe We Will Win chant. I mean, it, as a player, you feed off of that. You feed off your teammates. You feed off of the environment that you play in. And those kind of fans make this environment that much more fun.
We've got a drop ball over here. Stokich, along with San Luis, Fabinho, all battling for the ball. And San Luis and Fabinho will go after it. That's kind of like a face-off in hockey. Stokich plays it into Milwaukee territory, and Liete is there to guide it back to Feenstra. Under 7 to play in the third. 10-0 Comets over the Wave. Now forward to Bennett. Taken away by the Comets. Here's Rodriguez. Lucas runs into a trio of black jerseys. San Luis tries to win it back. Lucas pops it forward to Perez. And then on back to Feenstra. Marcel. On back towards the Comets half of the field. Sosa retreats, gathers it up to Lucas. On back to Sosa, who plays it long, curling in towards Feenstra. Leo Gibson with 2 goals this afternoon. Max Talou has a goal. Stefan San Luis and John Sosa. That's the scoring for the Comets. Here's Pablo. And there's Phillip Surprise right there on the doorstep. And Surprise, Danny Waltman up with it. Meanwhile, gets it out to Gibson. Leo plays it near side to Sosa. John on into Leo, back to Sosa. John took a crack at it, stuffed, gets it over to Robert Palmer. Palmer down to the corner to Gibson. Here's Leo, marked closely by Banks. Leo hits the deck and plays it back to Robert Palmer. Looks like Leo gonna be all right, shaking up for a moment, stay in the game. Does he ever come off?
He's in the zone, he's in the zone. When your players are in the zone, you don't want them off. Especially if it's offense. I mean, the way he's been playing all year, having that many assists and being the point leader for the entire MISL, and there's some great people scoring goals in this league. And the fact that he's at top, and it's not even because he's scored so many goals, it's because he has so many assists. And that speaks volumes of the guy and how much he contributes to his teammates, not Max, just by scoring goals.
Oh, Max Talou. Thought he had a chance there, but Judson McKinney obstructed his path. The Wave will take over. Coming up on 4.5 to play here in the third. Still a ways to go. Kiros is there. Now left side, McKinney. On back to Victor Kiros. Now Carlos Munoz. On back to Victor. Comets keeping their shape. Now they play over to Victor. Left back for Greenfield. Now down to Kiros. Kiros off the boards. Vasitpour is there. Greenfield's got it. Leo steps in, intercepts that pass, bangs it off the boards, and will clear it to the center circle. Milwaukee takes it there. Now left wing Kiros. Front
team
center McKinney.
Solid. Absolutely solid right now.
Milwaukee making the Comets work hard here. See if their hard work will pay off. The Wave kind of working the ball around the Comet perimeter. It's Greenfield holding, fires it off of Talou. Out of bounds it goes. And then Talou and Greenfield with a bit of conversation there. It's starting to get heated between these two teams.
Little chippy.
It is. A drive from three. And that one out of bounds off the foot of Carlos Munoz. Danny Waltman will have it with 3:32 left to play in the third. And the Comets holding a 10-0 lead over the Milwaukee Wave. Rolled out to Lucas. Lucas Rodriguez. What a year he's had. Built on a good season last year. Has become even a better player. Into the corner to San Luis. Stefan San Luis shielding away the defender, strong on the ball. Back to Lucas. Oh, into the middle of Perez, who tried to one-time it. It goes through, and Milwaukee comes up to clear. Across the half line. Asadpour able to touch it back to Danny. And over to Stokic. Stokic dives in and loses the ball. Under three to play in the third. Pablo's got it now. Arcio Liete, who really was, as he was leaving the field, the fans were having fun with him, and he was having some fun right back. Wins the ball from Asadpour by Palmer. A drive save made by Paul Waltman. What a save. What a drive by Arcio Liete, and a foul called on the way.
Unbelievable.
Look at it again here. Liete with some great defense wins it, and then a cracking shot that was saved by Waltman. That one was a heater, and Danny couldn't hang on to that one.
The best part about it is after he makes the save initially, there's guys there to clean up the garbage. They're taking care of it. They're not letting the ball sit there for Milwaukee to come in and shoot again. They're getting rid of it. We got a bunch of blue behind the ball, which makes this game that much more fun.
Here's Brian Harris. Brian with a left footer. He says, why not?
I probably would have done the same thing there, too. Except for I'm left-footed. That's another thing. This year, you see Brian Harris scoring goals left-footed. You see Lucas had some unbelievable goals, and they were right-footed. For being a left-footed player, amazing.
Out of bounds off the Comets. It'll be a corner kick coming up to the wave with 1:23 left to play in the third. Comets leading 10-0. Here's Fabinho trying to hit it on the volley, and that one will go out of bounds. That one right into the area of the Galaxy girls. Asadpour forward. It goes to Milan Ivanovic. Ivanovic in there again. He's played a few shifts this afternoon. Now Milan is a guy who really worked hard early in the season to improve his game. Now Philip Surprise wins the ball, trying to leave it for a teammate. Lucas comes up with it for the Comets by one player, by another. Gets it over to Stokic. Here's Stefan, a drive, save made by Feenstra. Under a minute to play in the third. Milwaukee clears it towards the half line. Asadpour is there. On back towards Danny. Comets calmly get it up to Ramon Palmer. Palmer forward, looking for Gibson. 27 seconds left. A whistle and a foul called against the Comets. Oliveira up to Everton. 20 seconds on the clock in the third. Everton, down to Fabinho. He fires, save made by Danny, ranging to his left. Another drive up and over the glass. The Comets will have it. That one was coming at Danny at a weird angle there, and he somehow ranged and made a left-handed save.
His reaction has been, I've never met a goalie that reacts quicker than Danny. And playing against a different group of goalies before, and Danny's got the fastest hands that I've seen in a while.
His team is leading 10-0, winding down here in the third. A long one from three. And that one goes into the tunnel, and that's the end of the third quarter. Stick around. The fourth and final frame is coming up next. The Missouri Comets 10, and the Milwaukee Wave nothing. You're watching the Major Indoor Soccer League Playoffs.
Lee Summit, Missouri.
Lee Summit. All right, let's hear from McKenna for helping us out here. From Lee Summit. Now, McKenna, we're going to have some fun. We're going to do Name That Tune, all right?
We've come to the fourth quarter. We're live at Independence Event Center alongside Ryan Jung. This is Nick Vassos. Comets take a 10-0 lead into the fourth quarter. And this is the first time in 2 years that the Wave have been shut out for three quarters. What will happen here in the final 15 minutes? Still a long way to go, and it's not out of the realm of possibilities for the Wave to climb back into this game. The Comets lead is only 10 points, and the Wave have had chances. We'll just have to see what happened. Look at Feenstra way off his line. Greenfield through the box. Cleared away by the Comets. Left side, Greenfield. Marked by Perez. Front and center, Quiros. Oh, a carpet monster jumped up on him. Sosa comes away with it. Here's Sosa. Oh, sidesteps. A player and a foul is going to be called on Milwaukee. It looks like Quiros is going to be guilty of the foul. That'll be his second of the half.
Kind of going off what you said, Nick, about it's 10-0, but you can't count Milwaukee out. If any team in the league can come back from 10-0 down in one quarter, Milwaukee has the firepower to do it. They got the coach to do it. They got the scheme to do it. So it's not over until the final horn goes off. But it is nice to see a 10-0 lead going into the fourth quarter, no matter what team you are or no matter who you're playing.
Comets cannot take their foot off the accelerator here. They play it forward to Gibson. Ball touched a few times by the Comets, and they get it up to Greenfield. Greenfield with a drive, and that one just wide. Comets lose it in the midfield area, and another try by Milwaukee. They keep getting their chances. They just haven't been able to convert. And we've seen the frustration on some of the players' faces, but they go back to work here, trailing by 10. Liete on the left wing. Banged it off of Palmer and the Comets. Now Gibson, a long one from three. Oh! Oh! Leo Gibson, Shazam! That one good from Green Valley, Missouri. The Comets lead 13-0.
Is that a four-pointer?
Oh, my.
That's the gamble you take. That's the gamble right there. It goes your way or it doesn't. What a goal by Leo.
Gibson, he now has the hat trick and 7 points on the night. What a huge goal by the Comets. Leo Gibson, the points leader in the league, leader in assists. Leo Gibson, a selfless player out there, on the field. Palmer gets the assist on that one. That's Ramon's third assist on the night. A wave have outshot the Comets 25-15. Here's Bennett to Pablo. Back to Ian. Now over to Banks. Into the middle it goes. Palmer left without the ball. Over to Bennett. Now down to the side, shot save is made, blocked actually by Ramon Palmer. And Danny Waltman scoops up his teammate and pats him on the backside.
Get behind that defense, let's go.
It's a great feeling as a defender to slide in and block that. Defense. The one thing that's not good about it is the fact that Danny hits you afterwards and leaves a handprint on your back. It's a stinger for a while, that's for sure.
12-21 left to play in the game. 13-0 Comets. Munoz kind of walked up and he sort of kind of gave up on that shot and that lofted it up into the air, and Danny Wallman will have it on the goalkeeper distribution. Carlos Munoz with 3 game-winning goals on the year. There's Danny Wallman throwing it long. Danny with 14 wins this season. He spent more time in goal than any keeper in the MISL. Minutes to play. Here's Danny. Boots it into the corner looking for San Luis. Fabinho with a touch up to Oliveira. Now Tony Walls got it. Here's Walls. Leaves it into the corner to Surprise. Back to Walls. Now front and center Oliveira. Luan slides it in there. Danny on the carpet. The wave couldn't get another crack at it. They maintain possession. Play it front and center to Fabinho. Now left side Oliveira. 11 and a half to play in the game. Oliveira's got a left wing. Banged off the boards. And it goes over the glass. It'll be turned over to the Comets. Once again, game 2 of this semifinal series coming up tomorrow night, 7 o'clock kickoff, live at U.S. Cellular Arena. CometsIndoorSoccer.com to watch that game live. Tom Wynn, Art Kramer will have the call for you. Last year's playoff series with Milwaukee was one of the wildest 3-game series I've seen in my life.
It was crazy.
You remember, you were there. Oh, Gibson's got it again. Can he make 4? Here's Leo. A shot. And a goal. Leo hammers it home. His 4th on the afternoon. And the Comets lead 15-0.
What Leo does.
He finishes. Nobody in front of him. Measured it, strikes it, and it's in. Wow.
I've always wondered what keepers think when that happens. It's a one-on-one. You can only do so much, and as on the other side, the attacker has so many options. It's almost a gimme.
And really, in a situation, the keeper's got to guess.
It's almost like a PK. You just got to kind of roll the dice and see what happens. But I don't know anything about goalkeeping, so I'm sure there's a little bit more that goes into it than that. But from an offensive point of view, you have so much to work with. It doesn't look like there's much for the keeper to go off of.
Restart there. Got close into Danny. The time of Leo's goal comes at 4:11. Again, that's Leo's 4th on the afternoon. Brian Perez comes up with the assist. Here's San Luis. needs to slide it over to Vaheen. He's got him open over there. Now he takes it himself. A rebound comes to Bennett. Here comes Milwaukee on the counter. Bennett down the right side. His shot is blocked by the Comets. Stokic there. Now Gibson. Manhandled from behind by Judson McKinney. Foul on McKinney in the wave.
This is one of those games you hope that nothing goes down to a cheap shot and someone's out for the next game. Someone gets ejected from this one for some stupid reason.
We need
hoping no elbows are thrown or anything like that.
Everybody needs to keep their poise and also stay healthy. The Comets are without Cody Andrews and without Alex Megson. Alex tore a knee ligament in the regular season finale at Milwaukee, a game in which the Comets won 9-4. And then Cody Andrews, when the Comets had that long break in February during practice, broke his ankle. Wondering if your phone rang at all, Ryan. There's a shot in there, and Fulton ranges to his left and covers up once again for the Comets. Waltman throws out to Gibson. Ossetpour calls for the ball and receives it. Vaheed, the team captain. On back to Danny. Waltman will boot it with his left foot. Danny is good with both feet. That's just amazing, the skill that he has with his feet as a keeper.
Unbelievable.
And that is such an advantage in the indoor game. You got a keeper who can play with his feet, you got something there.
I don't think I've seen a keeper get more assists than Danny either.
Danny?
I mean, he's not afraid to go forward. He's not afraid to slot a ball in for a shot.
2 to 3 assists this year for Waltman.
Yeah.
Here's Walls. Moves to his right. Leaves it for surprise. And they slide it through Waltman. Milwaukee is on the board. At 8:06 of the fourth quarter, it's Phillips surprise with Milwaukee's first goal. And that one just got through the five hole of Danny. Oh, Danny usually makes that save right there. He's not going to be happy about that.
He might throw his gloves after the game, but as long as they pull out a W, he'll be all right.
Tony Walls, the assist. And the Waves on the board. 8 minutes to play in the game. 15-2 Comets.
I think that's one of the best last names I've seen in indoor for a while. Surprise.
Surprise.
That's awesome. I feel like that's a promotional or a marketing campaign.
Surprise.
Goldmine.
He had 11 points for the Wave in 10 games during the regular season. 3 goals, 5 assists, 5 blocks.
It's kind of nice seeing fresh new faces with a team that's been around for so long. Not taking anything away from like Everton or Oliviero or any of those guys that have been here for a while. But to see the Wave have some new guys and those guys contribute, I mean, that's what you want to see for indoor. And that's what you want to see as a team that's been around for so long, is some fresh new faces that aren't afraid to get in the mix and score some goals and just roll their sleeves up and go to work.
We've got an official timeout on the field. 7:39 left to play in the game. The Missouri Comets 15, the Milwaukee Wave 2. You're watching the Major Indoor Soccer League playoffs. The first leg of this MISL semifinal series between the Wave and the Comets continues here in the fourth quarter. 7:24 left to play in the game. Fabinho down to Ian Bennett in the right corner. The ball rolled through Ian. Comets clear it. On up to Harris. Ryan Harris trying to slide it over to Saint-Louis. Feenstra way off his line. Gets it over to a teammate, Oliveira. Then to Bennett. Back to Luan, poked away by the Comets, recovered by Asadpour of the Missouri Comets. First leg of this game this afternoon, and game number two coming up tomorrow night. It's Monday night soccer at U.S. Cellular Arena. Harris for three, no good. Feenstra distributes out to Bennett. Ian Bennett to Oliveira. To McKinney, and now over to Victor Quiros. Forward it goes to Nicholas Pereira. Pereira banged it off the boards. There up front is Bennett, couldn't put it on target. Good play there by Pereira to Bennett. Comets trying to win the ball back. McKinney lets it roll through to Quiros. Now back to McKinney, into Pereira, looking to turn onto the defender, but first a whistle and a foul on the Comets. And that'll go against Brian Harris. And that'll be Brian's second of the half. Carlos Munoz will trigger the restart for the Wave with 6:12 left to play. And they're going to call timeout. Call a timeout here with 6:12. And we'll keep it right here. 6:12 left to play in this one. This is the fourth consecutive year Missouri and Milwaukee have met in the playoffs. The Wave won the first two series. The Comets won last season, advancing to the MISL Championship against Baltimore. Missouri handed Milwaukee only four. Missouri handed the Wave four losses during the regular season. And the Comets are the only team to win a game in Milwaukee in the last 2 years. Overall, the Comets are 5-2 in Milwaukee over the last 2 years, as we get ready for game two coming up tomorrow night. So we'll see what happens there. It's if Milwaukee holds serve on their home court, then it'll be a 15-minute mini game to decide who advances to the championship. And that'll be against either Baltimore or Syracuse, but Syracuse falling at home to the Baltimore Blast 20-7 this past Friday night. And game two of that semifinal series is set for Tuesday night at 6:30 Central Time in Baltimore. 15-2, Comets on top of the Wave, 6:12 left to play. Restart coming up to Milwaukee. Carlos Munoz behind the ball. He'll trigger the restart, fires it in there. Danny makes the save. And then cleaned up and kicked away.
Clean out the garbage.
Here's Munoz. Down to the corner to Oliveira. Oliveira. Now front and center it comes Liete. Liete down to the corner to Quiros. Slides it through the goal area. Boy, Bennett was there but couldn't put a boot on it. Gibson trying to clear it away. Munoz. A back heel over to Liete. Marcio Liete was having fun with the crowd when the first half ended. He was really hearing it from the fans, and he was giving it right back to them. Here's Liete. Moves to his right, cuts it back to his left, shot, and that one blocked by the Comets. I think that was Harris that was in there, or maybe it could have been Gibson. I'm not sure. It's going to be a Comets ball with 5 minutes and 20 seconds left to play. And Munoz called for that foul there. Here's Munoz with some pressure. I wonder if Tozer will, Coach Keith Tozer will consider using the sixth attacker at all in this game. We'll see.
It's getting close to that time. You need to get some goals.
Here's Bennett racing in. Save made by Danny again. Wow, Danny Waldman, another save. Now Gibson over to Rodriguez. Back to Talu. Back's Talu. Shot. Goal! Comets!
Huge goal.
17-2. Comets on top.
Did they count that as a three?
A three-pointer by Max Talud. The Haitian sensation. There's Rodriguez back to Max, who pulled it back. Set, fired. And that's a three-pointer, folks.
Perfect placement.
Look at that. It's a great view of it here from up top.
Oh, that's a three-pointer.
Ooh, that was close. Might have been. Let's see if they'll look at it here. Yep, they're going to look. It looks like the officials are looking at the replay right now. My guess, it's going to be a two-pointer.
Yeah, it looks like it was right on the line.
And that's the rule, right? If if the ball's touching
any
part of the
line. It's got to be behind the three-point line. So it's like NBA, if your foot's on the line when you shoot, it's a two.
Gotcha.
Can you get a two and a half? 17.5. It looks like it's going to stand. Not enough to overturn it.
Not enough to overturn it. So 18-2. And the second goal for the Haitian sensation, Max Talud.
That's a huge pickup for the Comets this time of the year. Get a goal scorer like that. He just has a nose for the goal.
Saint-Louis the other way. Feenstra makes the save, but Saint-Louis nearly came up with a rebound. The Comets almost win it back and think they have Milan. Now leaves it for Ramon, who fired in there. Feenstra had to make the save. Wow, the Comets just keep getting chance after chance after chance. Now front and center to Munoz. Munoz to Pereira. Nicholas Pereira moves to his left, leaves it. Here's a shot and a just off target there. I think that one hit the post. Danny just gave a big smooch to that post over there just to the right of him.
And next to the defenders, those are Danny's best friends.
Robert Palmer guilty of the foul. 3:42 left to play. 18-2, Comets on top. And we can now start looking towards game two. The Comets have appeared to have hold serve here as surprise fires one from three. And that one, too, just barely missed. So with 3:30 left to play, it looks like the Comets here are going to hang on. Not just hang on, but they're going to win this game against the Milwaukee Wave.
Best chance in all of indoor right here.
And force Milwaukee to win tomorrow night. We'll have all the action on CometsIndoorSoccer.com. 7 o'clock kickoff, live from U.S. Cellular Arena. Tom Wynn, Art Kramer on the call.
This is what I miss, the best part.
Hector's getting the crowd. Lavada KC loud and proud there at the end of the arena. Under 3 minutes to play. Comets in control, 18-2. Oh, gets through to Feenstra on Gibson. Oh, my gosh. He's hit it in the fifth time. Leo Gibson, 5 goals. And the Comets are crushing the Wave, 20-2.
Doing what Leo does. Miscommunication, unfortunate bounce, good goal.
And Leo does not miss.
He does not. And if he misses, he gets his rebound and usually scores.
Gibson now with 11 points on the afternoon. 11. Oh, my. Leo Gibson, the scoring leader in the league, assist leader in the league. What a game.
Is it safe to say MVP?
Yeah.
Strong statement for it. If not, he's going to win it. I mean, it's not just his stats. It's everything that has come with it. When he scores goals, when he's getting his assists, the team's winning games. And that's the main thing for anybody that's in his position, I think. For Leo especially, he's all about the team. He doesn't care if he has that many assists or that many goals. If the team wins, that's the main thing to him. But it doesn't help, or doesn't hurt, I guess, that you get a few assists and get your own goals here too.
Leo's 11 points are a Comet playoff record. And this afternoon, 4,774 here cheering on the Comets at Independence Event Center. On behalf of the Comets, thank you, Comet fans. We hope to be back here again in the MISL Finals, either against Baltimore or Syracuse.
Unbelievable crowd. So supportive, so enthusiastic. I mean, Even if there are empty seats, you don't know, because the way this crowd gets into the game, it sounds like there's 10,000 people on top of you cheering for you. And that's what you love to see as a player, especially on a Sunday afternoon when people have other obligations, I'm sure. But to come here, cheer on this team in this time of the year, you couldn't ask for anything better as a player.
Finally getting some good weather here in the Midwest. Climbing up into the 50s today, and some beautiful sunshine out there. So had a good crowd walk up here to this afternoon's game.
For sure.
Oh, there's a bicycle kick, and Milwaukee gets a tally, and it's Heverton. As the Comets make a mistake in the last third, it's 20-4. How about that bicycle kick? And how about the Comet fans standing up and giving a round of applause to Everton and that bicycle. What a beautiful goal. Look at this.
Great goal. Great touch.
Wow, what a goal by Everton.
Not much
beautiful.
You can do. Danny was kind of hung out to dry with it. Not much you can do. But the fact that these fans stood up, gave Everton a round of applause for that goal, and even when Surprise scored, I mean, that just speaks volumes for this group of fans that we have here. This fan base is by far one of the best fan bases I've ever seen, and that's in every sport. I mean, their passion is, it's unreal, and it's electric. And the time that they can bring you up, it's now. They're in the playoffs. They know that. They're just getting loud. And then I'm sure they're that loud at the watch parties for away games. Never got a chance to go to one. I'm sure they're just as crazy. I'm sure they yell just as much at the refs then as they do when they're here. And it just doesn't get any better than this as a player.
And the fans stand on their feet as the final minute here. Clock unwinds, 47.7 seconds left in the game. 20-4, the Comets in control. The Wave will have a restart here, right at the top of the arc.
Timeout Milwaukee, their second charge timeout of the half.
Liete is going to call a timeout with 47.7 seconds left.
Not quite sure Tozer even knows why he called a timeout.
And now the Comets.
Tomorrow's going to be a long day. You got to feed off of this and go into tomorrow. It's 0-0. This game, after the clock says zero, it's over. You move on to the next one, and you focus on what you got to do to get to the championship again. And I'm pretty sure these guys are going to know what to do. Vlaco's got the right mindset for it. We all were there last year. We had the taste of the championship. We played really well against Baltimore at their place. And these guys are hungry. And there's no doubt in my mind that they're going to come out tomorrow with a fire lit underneath them. But on the same note, Milwaukee's going to be doing the same thing. I mean, they got the reputation. They got everything going for them. They have a chance to go to the MISL championship. They're going to fight. They're going to fight until it says zero. And if it comes down to a 15-minute minigame, no one should be surprised.
We saw there Vlatko Andonovsky talking to his team. I would imagine when the year-end awards. There'll be more of them coming out as the MISL Championship gets underway. But I'm just curious how many votes that Vlatko might get for Coach of the Year.
I think he's made a strong case just based off of the fact that he's a first-time coach and the team is playing unbelievably well. And they're, I mean, I'm going to say this just because I'm a Comet. They're going to make it to the MISL Championship. And that's going to speak volumes for Vlatko as a coach.
Another goal there scored late, this one by Pablo. And that makes the score 20-6. It doesn't change the outcome of the game, just the numbers on the scoreboard. Pablo, his first postseason goal, and it looks like Munoz is going to get the assist. 20-6 our score with 23 and a half seconds left to play.
They don't quit. I will give Milwaukee that no matter what.
And they're going to send Munoz off. They're going to send.
I think it's Leo.
Send Leo off?
He must have said something Ryan didn't like. He got a yellow card for 23 seconds.
20 seconds left to play.
Nothing stupid.
Keep it easy, dog. Easy, boys, easy.
Well played.
And I guess they're going to just let the clock wind down, and that's it. They're going to pick up the ball. It's all over. It's all over, and game one goes to the Missouri Comets. Final score, 20-6 on the strength of Leo Gibson's five-goal, 11-point performance. Max Talou with two goals. He had a two and a three. Three assists by Lucas Rodriguez, San Luis, John Sosa. Also chipping in, and of course, Danny Waltman making so many saves for the Missouri Comets. For Milwaukee, just three goals. One by Everton, one by Pablo, and the other by Philip Surprise. Here are some of the highlights there, and as we look at Danny Waltman made just about every kind of conceivable save you can imagine there. Shut the door on the wave all afternoon. Oh, then how about that? Was it impossible?
Just stacking pads, doing what he does. No fear from that guy. I've seen him take shots off the face, get back up and make a save with his hand. It's crazy the punishment goalies and indoor take. And Feenstra made some great saves too. Like, I mean, nothing away from him. He's a great goalie, but I think the man of the match was Danny and the saves. He never gives up.
Incredible. There is John Sosa's goal in the second quarter. They gave the Comets a 10-0 lead. And then in the fourth quarter, Leo Gibson started it off with a three-point bomb from Green Valley. A great first game win for the Missouri Comets, thanks to Danny Waltman and Leo Gibson's brilliant five-goal, 11-point performance. Ryan, it's great to have you here. Come
always
back and see us. We hope the Comets have one more game here at Independence Event Center. That means they would be in the MISL Finals.
If that's the case, I'll be back. And I hope this fan base is just as electric as they are tonight. We just got to go one game at a time, and tomorrow night's just another game.
Game number two is coming up tomorrow night, 7 o'clock Central Time. CometsIndoorsoccer.com to watch that game live. Tom Wynn and Art Kramer will have the call for you live from U.S. Cellular Arena.